A warm welcome to the Institute of Biotechnology and Biochemical Engineering here at Graz University of Technology. My name is Regina Kratzer and I'm a researcher in the field of bioprocess development. In the report study, we provide the intensification and the scale-up of a bioreduction process. We oppose the biological and engineering constraints in a window of operation analysis. The bioreduction consists of the operational units, cell cultivation, bioreduction, and product isolation. And now I want to show you how this looks like in the lab. Most of the intensification and scale-up experiments were done by Thomas Axelsberger, who now describes the process in more detail.
So our starting point was shaken flask cultivation, which led to low cell densities and also low overall biomass yield. In an attempt to improve these parameters, we set up a fed batch fermentation process in this bioreactor with the goal of not only achieving high enzyme activities, but with a special focus on a balanced expression of both enzymes. We optimized this process regarding the growth and induction conditions to achieve in the end both high cell density and also high enzyme activity.
The biomass was further on used in the reduction, which was also done in a small steered tank reactor, like the one shown here.
The bioreduction was performed by the whole cell catalyst suspended in a two-phase system of hexane and water. This was done to enable in situ substrate supply and product removal, which is an important point due to the toxicity of these two compounds for the catalyst. Downstream processing was performed by in situ extraction in the same bioreactor using the same co-solvent. The integration of bioreduction and downstream processing using hexane minimizes the number of chemicals needed, and recycling of hexane in the process would further reduce the amount of organic waste produced. This would then meet the requirements for green chemistry.
Per batch, we were able to produce 20 grams of S1,2-chlorophenyl ethanol, an intermediate in pharmaceutical industry. At this point, I want to thank our co-authors, who are Professor Bernd Nitecki, who is also head of this institute, and Professor John Woodley from the Danzig Technical University. I hope you enjoyed our short video, and I wish you an exciting time while reading our communication.